हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम रुपिंदर, पीजीटी फिजिक्स। नाउ आई विल बी लेटिंग यू नो रिगार्डिंग द रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट फर्दर। वी हैव डन द रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट इन लास्ट वीडियो। इन दैट वीडियो आई हैव टोल्ड यू व्हाट इज़ बेसिकली रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट, हाउ द बेंडिंग टेक प्लेस। Now in this video, you can easily see the glass slab and the air interface. The bending of light occur when the light travel from air to glass and glass to air. So here in the diagram, two times the bending of light occurs while going from air to glass slab or glass slab to air. Basically what happens, why there is change in direction of light? Since there is change in speed, light travel maximum with the speed in air, and if we compare it with glass, it is 3 into 10 the power 8 meter per second in air, and in glass it is 2 into 10 the power 8 meter per second. So there is change in speed, so due to that there is change in the direction of light. So while light going in air, it is fast. When it goes in glass slab, its speed decreases, and again when it goes from glass slab to air, its speed again increases. So the change in speed is the cause of change in direction of light, and that is called refraction of light. But when the light ray is going along the normal, there is no bending occur. Though the speed changes, but there is no bending occur and light travels straight forward along the normal. But if there is a change, the light ray will not be going along the normal, then there is always a bending of light. The ray which is going from one medium to another is called incident ray. In second medium it is called refracted ray, and in the third medium again, which is air, which comes out, is called emergent ray. Light air to glass, it travel as an incident ray, and glass it is traveling as a refracted ray, and it will come out as a emergent rays. Now when light ray goes from rare to dense medium, it bend towards the normal. That is, example is air to glass. When it goes from dense to rare, it will bend away from the normal, that is glass to air. So this we have already also done, so again memorize this thing. Now optical object are those object through which light can propagate. These have to be transparent, whether it be a air, glass or water. So what are rare or dense medium? Dense medium and rare medium, the material which is having density less, those are called rare medium, in which the speed of light is more. What are dense medium, in which the speed of light is less, that are called dense medium, and density is more in dense medium. So this is the comparison between dense and rare medium. Always remember, dense medium density is more, speed is less. Rare medium density is less, speed is more. So whenever light travels from rare to dense medium, speed decreases and it will bend towards the normal. But when the light travels from dense to rare medium, speed will increase and it will bend away from the normal. So this is the type of refraction or bending which takes place when the light travels from rare to dense or dense to rare medium. Now you can see that the bending of light will also occur in different form in different medium. Bending in glass slab is more, but bending in water is less. Why? Because water is less denser than glass slab, and speed of light is more in glass than water. So we can consider it as air to glass bending will be more and air to water bending will be less. Now let us consider, in both the cases, if angle of incidence are same, but angle of refractions will be different. Angle of refraction in glass will be less than that of angle of refraction in case of water, since bending in glass slab will occur more because it is a dense medium. So refraction also depend upon the type of medium selected. Now again see the diagram. When a light ray is incident on from glass to air to glass slab, it will bend towards the normal, but there is no refraction occur.